An era came to a close last night in Creston. After 65 years, they played the last basketball game in the old Creston High School gymnasium. The old gym is like a scene out of the movie Hoosiers, a tiny facility packed with things like school spirit and small town pride. Next year, all of the games will be played in a new $5.5 million high school. Our Eye on Iowa reporter Dana Carden was there last night when they said goodbye to an old friend made out of wood, brick, and plenty of memories.
The old gymnasium played out its last game in front of a packed house. But on this night, they didn't come so much to see a basketball game as they did to see an old friend. In its day, the Creston High School gym was one of the finest around. But over the years, it came to be known as the Pits. Dark, small, and incredibly noisy.
We put in a lot of hard games in this old place, and I didn't realize it was this noisy when I was coaching here. I grant you.
The most distinguishing feature of this old gym, the 8 steel support beams that surround the court, always in the way of players and fans.
I've been jumping up and down tonight because they can't see both ends.
While there's no good place to sit, the favorite place is the balcony. Spectators are literally on top of the action.
You can see the scoreboard in both baskets from here.
Aaron, don't double up and leave that guy for the layup.
The Pit, with all of its shortcomings, has character. And it has more for those who have played on its shiny oak floor. It's a reminder of growing up, of simpler times and still remembered glories. A time when basketball was more than a game and the coach more than a man.
That was our primary goal in life, was to make the team and to have Harold Hopkins be proud of us.
And so they came on this night, old players, ardent fans, even members of the team, which in 1939 brought home the state championship trophy. They all came to say goodbye to the Pit. Dana Carden with an Eye on Iowa in Creston.
Bob Jones apparently stole it during the 1939 season, and Kim is now modeling it at this time. Also, we'd like to tell you, the trophy there on the table is the 1930 award.
As this gym hosts its final game before you tonight. Its name, ominous to opponents and amorous to Panthers, is simply the Pit. This is the place where the game is played in the laps of its spectators, a place upheld in all of its magnificent glory and nostalgia by the 8 steel pillars. The sounds of the Pit are symbolic of its heritage. The squeaking of high-top shoes on the old oak floor, the floor being swept between halves to the band's accompaniment, and the crowd's delight, the Rochester High School crowd chanting, "On ye Panthers," and the disbelieving cries of our adults in the balcony over a traveling violation or charging foul that was never called. Ah, yes, the balcony. This sauna gives our gym another touch of character. I'm sure our opponents experience a claustrophobic-like feeling when they step into the Pit and they feel the illusion of the ceiling being lower than their heads. Our new gymnasium will have no balcony, no pillars, no dead floors that leave opposing players dribbling down the court only without the ball. But it will have the pride and power of the Panthers. So, as we gather here for this final game and this special observance, let us not think of this occasion as the end of memory. Yes, the Pit's lifetime has ticked away, but the new Pit on town line will merely reset the clock. Thank you.
Thank you. it's the night.